Go from my window, for me, is about some sort of ghostly lover coming to this woman's cottagey window, I feel, but yet it does mention a harbour. The imagery that goes on in my head while I'm singing it is beautiful. And it reminds me of the Cathy and Heathcliff story. But then I'm sure that goes back much further. Particularly, she seems to be projecting some kind of masculinity outside the window, into the outside world, because she mentions the cuckoo. She also mentions the weather as well, and that he must stay outside, and that he must stay in the harbour, that he dare not come in. And just to quote Jung, I'm sure he didn't mention it first, but then it is to do with his psychology, about the animus in the woman, that she is failing actually to transform through a positive animus, because she is still saying there's a devil in this man. And I think she is perhaps safeguarding either her virginity or her sexuality. And so she wants to keep him outside, which is a great pity.
Do I seem to have been responsible for finding most of the and arranging most of the big ballads that we've done. Well, they're not exclusively. I've done other songs as well, like Go From My Window on the album. But the ballads have always been a major interest to me, yeah.
Said he. charm, she's lulled him to sleep.
Water is Wired is the result of me trying to feed in free improvisation into Steeleye. For the last 20 years I've been working with other musicians in interesting parts of the world, just making it up as we go along. And some of the reviews used to say things like, sounded like a traffic jam in Milan and whatever. And sometimes when you improvise you do have that. But what's happened now is that I like to improvise in a way that doesn't alienate people. And this song started off as a free improvisation. Then Gay said, I absolutely love this song. I would just love to sing one verse. So that's what we have now. The beginning is completely improvised. Then we have Gay singing the verse, and then it becomes a little bit formalised, and then we just sort of rumble away to the end. So this song is very dear to my heart in the way that I play. The reason why I like free improvisation is that you can make music with people from other cultures without having a common tune, and that, I believe, is the way to go. The way to go. Thank you. You Will Burn is a song that tells of villagers going to, in my mind, a midwife's bed at night, and first of all saying that we'll kneel by your bedside and we'll pray for your soul, and then they will be standing when she wakes up, and her bones will be broken and her blood will be shed, hands will be tied, and they take her to the forest and they burn her so that her soul will be saved. And for me, this, I have a slight problem with religion generally. I do believe that whatever I feel is very much to do with me and is within. And I think that people tend to project outwards to try and cure themselves. So to burn someone that they believe is a witch or possessed by the devil, it doesn't actually mean that they're possessed by the devil in my eyes. It means that the person the person themselves possessed by something that's unhealthy. And it's my way of illustrating this dilemma that I have. So it doesn't rest easy with me. So for me, this song is a little bit awkward. You know, and the gospel thing at the end, praise the Lord, another soul is saved, praise the Lord, to me is quite wicked, you know, because they believe that they're doing right. And yet, from my eyes, it's just like, wow, you know, can't they see what's going on here, you know?